Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, Force here, and today we will be taking a look at Toy Soldiers, developed by Signal Studios and published by Microsoft Game Studios. This is a tower defense game with a very interesting twist. It was originally made available for Xbox Live Arcade back in 2010, and the game is just now coming to the PC via Steam, and so today we're going to spend some time taking a look at it. We are going to begin with the campaign. There are two additional game modes available, the Kaiser's Battle and Invasion. This was DLC for the game that will be coming with the game if you purchase it on Steam for the PC. So this isn't anything that you have to pay for or anything funky like that. Let's go ahead and hop into the campaign, and we're just going to continue where I left off. I am a few missions into the game so far. What happens is when you play through the campaign, you slowly unlock additional turrets and upgrades and things like that. Now, I only have so much unlocked so far, but I just wanted to kind of show you where I was at currently and give you at least a little bit of time with the campaign and explain the basics to you before we hop into some of that DLC gameplay modes, which actually give you full access to everything, and that is going to include some of the controllable vehicles. All right, so that's the next wave coming in about 18 seconds. That is the money that I have to spend on turrets. Platforms, I can view it from up ahead. And there's also a sniper tower available. Now we're going to start off going down here and placing down. Whoops, there we go. Right there. Place down the red star. A chemical, really, really good against infantry. Large groups of infantry. We are also then going to place down a few of these level 1 mortars. I guess just one for now. Alright, so a couple of things I can show you. You can take control of these. Any of these turrets you're able to take control of. When you take control of them, you get a few things. You get extra range, you also get extra damage. Now, in addition to taking control of the turrets themselves, there'll be various objects, be it a sniper tower or an airplane or a tank. In this particular level, in the campaign right now, the only thing I have access to is actually the sniper tower. So I can take control of the sniper tower, go in there and get a couple of shots off. Now, as you can see, this is really far away. That's not really going to be the best. Maybe when people are coming up at that angle, it's actually going to do much. But right now, I don't think sniping from here is going to really do too much for me. So I'd rather maybe take control of some of these turrets. Let's grab this one, for example. Try to get a few shots off here. All right, so fire 3 rounds. They got slowed up there by the chemical. And look at that damage. Love it. Got a bit of money stored up here too. Try to get a few preemptive shots down there. All right, now I want to hop into this one as well. I will be dropping a mortar on this. There we go, and that is going to start off defaults taking care of itself. Also an 18 pounder, which is a level 1 howitzer. Obviously really, really good. It's got a minimum range, you can see there in that arc right there, but anywhere in the range above that it can shoot. It's got really, really great distance on that one. Those guys are trying to get through. Looks like we'll be all set though. So it's really one of the great things I found about this that, you know, I don't get in most tower defense games is the ability to choose how I play it. Sure, I can just place down my turrets, and of course you've got the standard stuff. You can get upgrades for these things. The upgrade for this particular one is locked at this point in the campaign. Again, in the DLC that we have that we're going to take a look at later, everything is unlocked and you can just go about it. But yes, there are upgrades, there are repairs, and you can sell. So basically if you make a mistake, you can go ahead and try to remedy that and drop another one of these howitzers here. Alright, there we go. And I would like to take control. Oh no, that's not what it, darn it. I thought, God, I did not do that right at all. I clicked on the wrong button, unfortunately. Grab this once we get to 800. I'm gonna drop another one of these. Should be there in just a moment. All right, there we go. So, let's try this one more time, huh? Drop the 18 pounder, there we go, wonderful. So now we got two of those going, and I'm gonna take control of this right here. There's my chemical. And once they get within range, you're going to notice the range error on the screen. I can just go ahead and get started. Why did I reload so fast? I really didn't get much done there at all. Alright. So, I'm going to lay some of this down. Slows them up. Allows some of the other damage to go through. We're going to go back here and pick up the machine gun. It's going to help in case any get through. And now's a good time, actually, even to hop in the sniper. Hop in, please. Not doing what I'm telling you to. You're supposed to be hopping in, thank you. I was like spamming on it. It wasn't working. All right, there we go. Just got those couple shots. That is good. Hop into this. We got another wave coming right now. There it is. So far, pretty interesting, huh? Not really your standard type of tower defense game. And I know this is an older game. Like I said, it was originally launched in 2010 for Xbox Live Arcade. But I heard nothing but positive about it, and I never took a look at it. I said, you know what? This just came to PC this week, and I want to show it off. And after I spent an hour or so with it, I said, this is great. I think that people on my channel, at least some of them, might enjoy this. So let's go ahead and show it to them, shall we? All right. Now, let's go start to get some upgrades here. We can get upgrade for the mortar. We can't yet for the chemical. This is just one of those things where you unlock it as you progress through the game. And I haven't unlocked this yet. Just not far enough in the campaign. I actually spend most of my time in the DLC modes, interestingly enough. All right, so let's upgrade these here. 1,000 for that. There's going to be a little timer there. Not very long, though. All these things seem to upgrade fairly quick. All right, look at these guys charging in here. That's pretty obnoxious. I'm gonna grab the sniper tower here, try to get some of these guys. If they start to get too close here. Ammo's there on the lower left, so as soon as you start to run out, you're made fully aware. Yeah, there we go. The horse still continues to move, even after its master's dead. How weird is that? Let me quickly show you everything that we have. Oh, we got some of those coming in. All right, so I just want to quickly show you. So this is the chemical one, good against light infantry grouped up. That's just good anti-infantry right here in the machine gun. We also have the mortar there, the big howitzer, and this last one, which is currently locked, is the anti-air turret. It just simply will unlock once we start to encounter anti-air. We aren't quite there yet, though, so not that big of a deal. It's not yet unlocked. With those things there, go ahead and get some shots off in the sniper tower. Doesn't do much, but it's something. Let the turrets take care of a lot of the rest and get a few shots off. I wish there was a, like a weak spot or something. That'd be good for the sniper. There's not, though. Wonderful. And what are we protecting them against? I can show you quickly here. That's our toy box. So yeah, it's just an entire toy setting. It's like those little army men that we had when we were children. Let's upgrade him. Got some guys coming across the battlefield. One more thing I can show you here that I have yet to is this, barbed wire. Barbed wire gets placed to do what barbed wire does, slow up infantry. So you just drop it down, it's gonna slow people up. Put one across this road as well. Very, very inexpensive as well. You can notice the money there hardly going down. Very, very cheap. Just gonna put this all the way across, in fact. Why not? There we go. Now, do we have any more down over here? Nothing made it through. Good. All right, next wave coming. Going to be some more cavalry. And we also have, there we go, some infantrymen. I will take control this time of the mortar. So again, it is important to keep in mind that taking control of these things does give you benefits. You don't always just want to let it all be automated. You get the extra damage from this, and you, oh my gosh, and you get a, holy heck, hop out of this really quick, get out of it, there we go, place that down. Stop him. Getting close. Blow up the barrel. That was too far away, darn it. All right, good, good, good. Everything's good. Now we got some, once I got that mortar upgraded, let's upgrade this one. And we can upgrade the howitzers as well. It costs a lot though, don't quite have that yet. Can't quite afford that yet. All right, where are these coming from? There we go. Coming from over there, huh? And he's gonna obviously bust his way right through the barbed wire. They're not really that affected by that at all. We got this side here. Reload faster, please. It's terrible. Oh, shucks, we need a repair. Always gotta keep an eye on for those repairs too. Let's upgrade that. Can we upgrade this one as well? No, not yet. All right. Repair that quickly. Oh, you know what? That's a bad idea. While it's repairing, it's not firing, which is pretty much expected, but I wasn't thinking about that for a second. Let's try to help here with some snipes. Now in the upper left-hand corner, that shows you, see that 20 right there in the upper left? That shows you how many things you can let through. And this is about to go through. No! No, stop! Yeah, are you serious? That really work. It's ridiculous. Okay, should have taken control of this from the get-go, huh? Would have been a lot better. I can't believe I let that one through. Oh, no, 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 no. We need repair back here. No, not yet. Everything's good. Could upgrade these. It's gonna be a good idea. Just go straight for it. Pick up this while... All right, wonderful, wonderful. Now we got the big dude coming, and he is going to, this is a boss guy here. He's coming in 8 seconds, and I want to get some of this down because he does bring infantrymen. So this will help against them. Come on, you can do it, there you go. This helps slow up the infantry. Any more upgrades that we can get? Again, we can't upgrade that. So he is all the way, where is he? We can't even see him yet. This is the boss dude. Yeah, that's right, bosses. Upgrade that. Can't afford to. Almost, not really. All right, so, let me grab the level 2 howitzer. Wonder if this is gonna hit him. Should be close if it doesn't even hit him directly. I think those guys will be actually taken care of from my close range stuff. Yeah, look at them. They're getting destroyed while they're walking through the barbed wire. So this is a good time to use these to just try to do as much damage as possible to this guy. I'm a bit concerned, though, because he is pretty massive. Yeah. I think that thing's just going to roll over my turrets. Oh, boy. We're getting a few... 3 pop shots here, though, without him responding much. All right, it's getting closer and closer. All right, so now I'm actually gonna sell this and drop one of these. Let's drop one of these too, just because he's so close, I can't even hit him with it, you know? So let's go ahead, get one of those. Now I gotta pay attention to repairs here. Yeah, wow, that got destroyed in about a matter of 3 seconds. So look at these, look at this thing. He just loves to beast my stuff. Try to let infantry take care of those. Do more damage, do more damage. No, I'm looking the wrong way. Turn around, thank you. Oh, wow, really? Reload right away? Seriously? Ridiculous. This thing takes to reload it every, like, 2 seconds. Unbelievable. Do more damage. I'm really concerned that he's about to roll over my thing. This is unbelievable. I do not know. There we go. Come on, reload, reload, reload. Must destroy Tsar tank. We've only got one through so far. I mean, so far this has been a pretty successful mission. And that mortar just blew this up. Oh, it's looking decent. Things are looking decent here. Come on, reload. I think we're gonna get it, I do. Grab that. Remember, extra damage. Yeah, we got him. Piece of cake. SAR tank. It's really close, I'm not sure yet. He's just standing so close right now. Actually, now I'm really concerned that those guys are just gonna make it through. Time to switch focus. All right, I just gotta go for him. I don't care if a couple of them get through. Oh no. Damn it. He's gonna destroy it. He destroyed it. It's dead. It's getting obliterated right now. He just rolled it over. God, you gotta be kidding me. I really thought, oh man. I think if I just focused him down, probably would have had it, but no big deal. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the other game modes. So there you go, guys. That is how the campaign works now. What is going to happen is what you saw there. There are just more missions. In fact, let me show you really quickly. Under campaign, level select. So that was mission number 3, and we've got, I believe it's a total of 12. And again, as you progress through, you will unlock upgrades for your turrets, more turrets, things like that. Now, let me jump into one of the DLC modes to show you this. Now, what I'm trying to do here, now there, each of the DLCs has 3 levels available. So here are the 3 for invasion. And then also, the Kaiser's Battle has 3 available as well. So each of the DLCs added 3 levels. And I'm most interested in invasion though. I really enjoyed that the most. So, let's go ahead and take a look at this. Now, the great thing about this is going to show you vehicular control as well. Specifically, we'll be using airplanes here. Still has a sniper tower. All the turrets are available, as well as their upgrades. And this one, we're fighting off aliens. It's so interesting to me that DLC for so many games, like, let's add aliens or zombies. And that is like the premise of so much DLC. But I thought it was kind of interesting here. Quite enjoyable, especially given the setting, you know, this kind of toy box environment. Alright, so, there it is. UFOs are coming. First round UFO, so the first thing we are going to want is anti-air. Anti-air needs to go on one of these big tables, and that is Archie. Archie is the anti-air. Now, in addition to that, you're going to notice, alright, so here are various turrets available. Those are the platforms to place them down. Those are all the ones that we have. And we have got the sniper tower, which you saw before, but this time we have use of the Mustang. Now with this, you've got your basic air-to-air weapon here, and you also have the ability to drop bombs. But that's not going to do me much good right now. Now I need to focus on UFOs. Let's get these UFOs, huh? The really cool thing too about flying the aircraft is you really get to see, like, look at that toy box stuff there. It's great. It's got a good, without any actual written humor, just the vibe is a bit humorous. And I think that kind of lightheartedness can be really good. Now you're going to notice the queued up there. We've got some alien infantrymen coming up, and they're coming in 8 seconds, so I better get down. So we eject out of the airplane and get ready for these guys, which are coming in just one moment. Let's see where they're coming from. There's the arrow for them. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and put some anti-infantry stuff right here. That's going to help a lot. I want to get back in the plane. There's a short cooldown. I believe it's about 10 seconds after you destroy the plane before you can get into another one. But obviously, I am beyond those 10 seconds now. Alright, so let's go ahead and do some bomb dropping here. Look at that, huh? And then you can pick back up into this vision and go straight back to the UFOs. Upper right corner also shows you the number of the each enemy remaining. What's that? 5 out of 40 UFOs, 6 out of 40 UFOs destroyed for us? That is sort of a little objective. It's not mandatory for the mission. What it's going to give you, we get a lot of, let me jump out of this, a lot of money. I want to get some more stuff down here. Drop a howitzer. What, are they really getting through? Oh man, I really thought that those were taken care of. Wow. That's annoying. Drop a couple of those there. I think he just took care of the rest of that. All right, now we got some more foot soldiers coming through. Go for that, and now we head back here. Now, it's interesting that the sniper tower is available because I feel it's kind of pointless when you have a plane that can carpet bomb. Like, I have no desire of hopping into the sniper tower. Maybe there's something I have to assume that it's better suited for, though. But right now, I'm just all about this. Yeah, that's much cooler to me. And you can also drop it on things. That time it didn't land on them, but you can. Here's a slight cooldown. So yeah, I believe it's about 10 seconds after you crash a plane before you can hop into another one. We got some more of the foot soldiers coming here. Let me get one of those there, the mortars. And let's upgrade that right away. And actually, why don't we upgrade the howitzer as well? We'll go back into the plane. I have to be honest, I really find myself enjoying this. It's a 2-year-old game, but this is probably one of the most fun tower defense games that I have honestly ever played. Just very, very interesting. What do we got next? Blimps? All right, whatever. Let's go get those blimps. Before we do, though, crash the plane. it seems so wasteful that you have to crash the plane every time you want to eject out of it. All right, we'll upgrade that, and very close to upgrading that. Not quite yet, though. Let's just wait 1 second. There we go. Okay, upgrade that. And now we hop in the Mustang. As soon as the cooldown wears off, time to take care of some blimps. This is the most fun tower defense game I have ever played. I can say that without hesitation. And I'm surprised that for a game that, you know, came out 2 years ago on Xbox Live Arcade, that I'm just now getting around to playing to it. But I'm glad that I did. And this is one, when it says unit destroyed, that's one of your towers that were destroyed. So I'm going to crash into him and go back and try to fix whatever I lost there. What was it that I lost? Right here. Can't quite afford that yet. Darn it. All right, forget it. We'll wait. Oh, there it is. Great. Just want to get that down for future once we do get some actual reason to have it. Now, this is bad. We have got some airplanes launching. Gonna take care of those. They can do the same thing I can do, which is dive bomb my stuff, so pretty crucial that I try to get these out of the air. Get this too, and actually, there we go. Alright. Come on. Turn around. Another unit destroyed. Not too happy about that. Most definitely the guys dive bombing here. Got some of these. Must drop them. There. When you crash into that, you do get damage done, though, so it is not a complete loss, you know. 3 seconds left until we get into the plane. Alright, so I'm going to go as far as I can with this. I expect fully to just die at some point, but I think we'll continue to play this. Invasion mode is pretty awesome. It's a lot of stuff going on right now. And I crashed. Wonderful. And I lost another building. I need to repair that. Go. What did I lose? Oh my gosh. Ah, shucks. Can I repair it? Yes. Repair that one as well. There we go. Took a lot of damage on those things. That was pretty much all from the planes, which are no more. They actually have finally been taken care of. That one's dead. Good. Okay. Motion sick here. Just trying to turn around. That other blimp go? Oh, the other blimp's gone. Wonderful. All right, now time for UFOs. We do have some horsies coming. A couple seconds. Probably drop out of that. Oh, they're coming right now. Ugh, look how fast. Look at that. The countdown timer, like, so finished before it even starts. Repair that. Get one of those. Get that, and I'm gonna upgrade it right away. Because that is something that could definitely use an upgrade. And I'm gonna upgrade that as soon as I can. 1800, can't do it yet. All right, it's fine. So yes, total of level 3 upgrades. This one's upgraded to level 2, so it's got a little bit more to go before it's fully there. Let's upgrade that one. Let's hop back in the Mustang. And then pick up another one. See that? Crashing in does actually help. Does actually do something. 4 seconds left. It's fine. More airplanes coming, shucks. All right, so we're gonna hop right back in the Mustang. Check to see if there's any more of these guys. Oh, they're pretty much all taken care of. We have fire trucks coming, whatever the heck that's supposed to mean. Why they're fire trucks, who knows. I should get some upgrades. I just keep crashing the plane, but it's the only way to get out of it. It costs 2,000 upgrade. Needs a repair. Back in the plane. Yeah, getting that anti-air upgrade really important to help against these bomber planes. Get it. Ish. Wonderful. More fire trucks still flying around. All right. You have to be careful not to bomb your own stuff. Crash into it. Oh man, you seriously missed that much? That's unbelievable. Gonna hop in, get that extra damage. UFOs are coming. I wanna make sure I get those soon. UFOs and blimps. Oh, there's so much taking place right now. All right, guys. Well, that is the game. I mean, there's really not much else to show you. It's a tower defense game. I'm really glad that you got to see the vehicle flying, though, or the airplane flying. And again, there are also tanks that are something else you can control in the game, and hopping in the sniper towers as well. Although, again, I've kind of found that useless when you have access to things like these. When you don't have the airplane, sure, fly around, just use a sniper tower, get a couple long distance pop shots off. But with an airplane, please. Woo! All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully, you have enjoyed this gameplay here of Toy Soldiers. Not too much else to see. This is something that I definitely give a thumbs up to, especially for the price point. If you like tower defense games, for $9.99, you can get this on Steam right now. It is currently on sale. I don't know if this is region based though, but for me, it's on sale for $7.49 here in the U.S. I'm not sure about other regions. Unfortunately, couldn't tell you. Either way though, even just at $10, pretty cheap for is some pretty solid entertainment, again, especially if you like tower defense games. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you like the content, please subscribe. Also be sure to check out my website, 4strategygaming.com. Keep watching and keep owning.